All right. Well,
I just like this leading. Go ahead. This is
all right.
A great story.
How would you like to get a deal on something that is so good it should be illegal?
That's right. 23 ABC's money expert and legality expert Denise Winston has the inside scoop on how to get stolen goods without facing charges. You're not talking about actual stolen goods.
I am talking about stolen goods.
Okay, then. This gets even better.
Well, guess what happens? So the police departments and sheriff departments have all of this property that has been seized by criminals.
Right.
What do they do with it when they can't return it to their rightful owner?
They put it in the storage room.
After a while, they got to get rid of it. And they can turn a profit. So what happens is you can take a 30-second commute to your computer,
okay,
and you too have access to these deep discounts on stolen property, but it's legal.
Okay. All right, so where do we start?
I still feel guilty, though. I mean, just knowing that this was somebody else's.
Well, they did their best effort to try and get back to them. And if there's no serial number, what are you going to do?
Right.
They can't just sit in these property rooms. Then we're going to have to pay for those facilities to be.
Right.
So first thing you want to do, there's two websites you can go to. First one you want to go to is propertyroom.com.
Okay. Right.
Now, this website has contracts with police departments and sheriff's departments across the United States. And what they do is they auction off all of that inventory.
Okay.
So when you go there, you are going to find smartphones, you're going to find jewelry, art, you name it. It's amazing. The best part is everything is real. There are no fakes. And the deals, you can start bidding at $1.
Oh,
wow.
Okay. Oh, that's really nice.
Then there is the surplus or publicsurplus.com.
Okay.
Now, when you go to this site, this is where public agencies has a huge inventory of stuff they either have overpurchased or that they want to decommission.
Oh.
Now, if you're self-employed or you're in business, this is where you can find heavy-duty equipment. You can find office supplies, sporting goods, school supplies. It's all there.
Wow.
And it's cheap,
it's
right?
It's very cheap.
Okay.
Now, a couple things you want to keep in mind when you are on these sites. Number one, you have to pre-register in order to participate in these auctions.
Okay.
Number two, you want to make sure you know if there is a return policy.
Mm.
You also want to factor in shipping when you're looking at this deal. And to top it off, you want to make sure you're not overbidding. So check out a site like PriceGrabber.com to make sure you're not just in the bidding war and you're just ready
get carried away by the
exactly. But you know, before this was a big secret, now everybody has access with that 30-second commute to their computer.
Nice.
Okay.
All right.
PropertyRoom.com, Public Surplus.
.com
are the two to go to.
Yep.
See, don't have to be like that one reality show, Storage Wars. Have you ever seen that one?
Yes.
Where they battle over the storage.
And you
don't even know what's in it.
Junk in the
You know, they do that with luggage. Well, they do that with luggage, too.
Right.
There's actually a new show on that. And you can even go to a store in Alabama where you can actually buy the stuff that is unclaimed property.
You'd get nothing but my, like dirty laundry and
my old socks and stuff like that. All right. Denise Winston, thank you as always.
You're welcome.
Oh, there
great
you go.
Tips.
PropertyRoom.com.
It is 626. Right after the break, we'll bring you the